Okay. Please be seated, everybody. And let's go to the announcements. Thank God it's finally snowing, my gosh. Finally. We got some cold weather. Yes. Fantastic. Okay. Announcement is January 24th, 2016. You gotta love the snow. You gotta love it. Oh my goodness. Okay, next please. Holy Blessing celebrating the birth of True Father Sun Myung Moon. That is the official title. Amen. Date is February 13th, 2016. That is a Saturday. Time will be 10 a.m. here in the main sanctuary. Second generation couples who return after this date will do so as first generation. First generation couples returning after this date will need to go through 40-day separation, 3-day ceremony, and indemnity stick. That's what prophesied in the Bible. The first will be last, the last will be first. And we've been telling the, of course, the Korean seniors, they all know this is the case. It's amazing because even just in the last month, we've had some now higher and higher level senior Koreans, coming to receive the blessing. And now one of the brothers from the 124 couple, that's quite senior, who had a direct relying and relationship with True Father, is now preparing to actually travel worldwide, wherever, to speak and testify. So you see now the senior members, God is moving, the Holy Spirit is moving, the Spirit is convicting them in their heart. They know what is wrong, right? And the last is first, the first is last. It's amazing that we're living in this time, and right now, we're living in it, folks. Next, please. Okay, to volunteer or ask for questions, please join weekly meetings of the event management team each Sunday in the library from 2:30 to 3:30, and then Lourdes Schwartz will be leading that. Last week, how could I forget Lourdes? Greg, Tim, and Lourdes, but please speak to Lourdes if you want to join in on the weekly meetings. Okay, next please. True God's Day Midnight Service is coming up February 8th, 2016. That is a Monday, and it will be from midnight to 1 a.m. here in the main sanctuary hall. Join us in honoring God as we begin the seventh year of Chungi. And, of course, we'll have the new calligraphy that day as well. So join us for that. Okay, next, please. Next, Ancestor Liberation, April 10th, 2016. The time will be here, 10 a.m., here in the main sanctuary. Is it the main sanctuary? Is that correct? Yes, in the main sanctuary. Online registration is available, so please sign up for next Ancestor Liberation. Next, please. Freedom Society seminars have resumed. Kuk Jinim is in Las Vegas at the SHOT Show 2016, and he got snowed in, folks. He got snowed in. So he was going to be back for today, but he got snowed in, and he'll be back on Tuesday. But wasn't that an amazing Holy Spirit gospel dance performance that GNM did last week? Did you see that? That was unbelievable. I couldn't see it because I was facing this way. So I went home and watched it on the TV, on the internet. Incredible. Wow. She is so anointed and gifted. We thank her for that incredible Holy Spirit dance. We pray that she does it every week. No, maybe that's very tiring. We'll try to make some teams, but at least she could do it often. That is beautiful. What a beautiful offering. Such an elegant display of, I love how it's like the spirit world dancing, giving glory to God, and to True Father. So that was amazing. We thank her so much for that. And Freedom Society have resumed. January 14th, we discuss legal issues surrounding the federal tax, income tax. And join us for our next meeting on January 28th. The location, that's this Thursday, correct? Yes. Car Factory Conference Room, Lawrence Valley, PA. Time is 7 p.m. Be in for a wonderful seminar and discussion period. People who have been going, let me see, show of hands, how many of you have been going? Isn't it an exciting night? It's a very exciting night, okay? So next, please. Please join us for that night. Blessing rings engraved with True Father's signature, the King of Kings' name is back. You can't erase the King of Kings, fools. So contact William Gage, eblessings88@gmail.com for more information on those beautiful, professionally crafted rings. And that signature is from one of Father's beautiful calligraphies. Okay, so it's a real original. Okay, next please. Pre-order your Constitution booklet. You can order your Constitution booklet today. It will contain Constitution in three languages. For details, go to the website, sanctuary-pa.org, for the information on the Constitution of the United States of Chanilguk. Yes, please. Next, please. Official Sanctuary Church 2016 calendar is now available for pre-order, and the donation proceeds will benefit the rebuilding of the worldwide ministries. So not only tell time, tell the date, but also help the worldwide ministry. Amen. Next, please. Our website, sanctuary-pa.org. Check out the new tabs, new features, new whole section on True Father's quotes, True Father's words, True Father's proclamations. Very, very comprehensive quote system. Also, it is being connected with some of the other sanctuary sites. Is that correct? Where's my internet, guys? Where's the arm on this? Is he here today? Okay, it's being connected, right?
It is connected.
It is connected. Okay, there you go. Okay, so definitely check it out, sanctuary-pa.org. Okay, next please. New website, sanctuarybleslife.org, and this is also connected to the main website. Look at, check out the new Blessed Life section, prepare for the blessing, blessed life, etc. More and more content being added to that on a daily, weekly basis, right? Okay, next please. Needed bookshelf donation for Sunday school. If you guys have bookshelves you're throwing away, or your heart just stimulates you to buy a new one for the kids, send it over, and so we can use it for the Sunday school, put in some real biblically based, you know, textbooks and different types of study material so that the children can be filled with the word, right? Faith increases by what? Hearing the word, right? And so by reading the word, hearing the word, faith increases, the Holy Spirit's presence can come. Amen. So if you have some stuff, bookshelf you're throwing away, just bring them on down here. Okay? Next, please. HSU sign up. Sign up today for HSU spring trimester class. It's terrible that the spring is coming so fast. It's so horrible. Last year we had a 6 months winter, which was fantastic. It was fantabulous. It was excellent. You know, spring is coming. You know, that means ticks are coming too, right? That's why I don't like the spring. I like going out in the winter. No ticks, no mozzies, no crazy chiggers and, you know, things that bite you and stuff like that. In the South, you know, they have the bugs that are called the chiggers, right? They bite your feet. But in the winter, you don't have to deal with any of that. But sign up for the upcoming spring trimester. We have some amazing, amazing classes this trimester. Check out our online location classes at website sanctuary-pa.org. Click the HSU tab for more info, and a short presentation from each of our spring trimester class leaders will be given. Let me ask Mrs. Carrie Williams, where is she? Hey, there's the Holy Ghost redhead. Let's welcome her up to give an intro on that. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. I'd like to invite up all of our HSU class leaders to come on up. And you're going to hear from them what they're going to be offering you this coming spring. So come on up, and we're going to do it in order of Monday through Saturday in terms of the order in which the classes are being given. Everybody, come on up, and let's first start with Tammy. And if we can go to the next slide, Tammy's going to be giving a class on fascinating womanhood. Tell us about it, Tammy.
Thank you. This is an awesome book. It changed my life. It was given to me by Emerald, hey, my daughter in Korea, and it is a must read for every woman. So basically, Helen Andelin is the one who wrote the book, and I'll just read what she's... She was born in 1920 and raised in a dentist home, a happy home where education was emphasized. She attended college and though her three sisters and three brothers also became doctors. Even though times were hard, working in a malt shop for 10 cents per hour, sewing curtains and ironing sheets for my parents' motel, the Depression was a time when people worked together and appreciated simple things. Okay, so basically this book has been translated into, how many languages? Korean, French, Portuguese, Russian, Japanese, not Chinese yet. So basically, I think that most of these, well, it's so much in one book, but I have learned so much. I've read, I kid you not, thousands and thousands of books, okay? I love to read. This book has changed my life the most, and for all your husbands out there that want your wives to be better, happier wives, you should come to this class. So, okay, thank you so much. Bye.
Thank you, Tammy. Tammy O'Brien, fascinating womanhood. Next up, I'd like to invite Lisa Ellenson to tell us about her class being offered on Tuesday nights. And you can switch to the next slide, please.
Okay. Oh, I don't have my picture of my Jesus. I'm sorry, my voice is kind of shot. So, anyway, this class is Right to Life, Firearms Under God's Authority is the title of the class. Basically, it's the textbook that we'll be using is called Why Christians Should Not Give Up Their Guns. God is a creator. He has authority over life and death, and we as his children are also endowed with that blessing. Because of the fall of man, though, Satan took over this world, and now he thinks he has power over life and death. So basically the class, a lot of people think it's just going to be about shooting. It really isn't. It's a class that's going to give you a mindset and a heart of what it means to be a child of God in the world we're living in now. So through divine principle, through the Bible especially, and through Father's own words, we're going to look at the fundamental components that are necessary for preserving dominion, because y'all know it's all about dominion. And we'll also, of course, cover the skills and the tools needed. Yes, we will be shooting. The class runs 11 weeks, and in the spring, we will be shooting. We're here to take back authority from Satan and give it back to our Father. So. Oh, Tuesday nights at the car plant, 7 o'clock to 8:30, we will be serving snacks.
Amen. Thank you, Lisa. Next up is Jim Stevens, and I will be, Jim and Hiromi Stevens, and I will be reading on his behalf. His class is also Tuesday night, online only, and his class is God's Design for Men, Women, and Sexuality. And each week, the class is going to be presenting a summary of the work of some experts in the field of marriage enrichment or the scientific differences between men and women. Did you know there were differences between men and women? Well, you're going to study them in this class with emphasis on trying to understand God's point of view. And you're going to be watching a short video or read material in preparation, and then write a reflection or inspiration, and then share it with one another during the class. So that promises to be a really exciting class. Next is Wednesday, Preparedness Peace. I'd like to invite up Neil Angelina to explain. Let's welcome him.
Thank you. Yeah, on behalf of Arthur Noren, Arthur prepared about 20 years for this, so he wrote up a few notes here. he's preparing. Bible quote, Hebrews 10:23-25. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how we may spur one another on towards love and good deeds. Let us not give up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but let us encourage one another all the more as we say the day approaches. The book is absolutely Arthur's third favorite book of all time, he said. I guess he has divine principle and the Bible ahead of that. But Preparedness Peace, a Bible-based emergency and disaster preparedness course developed by two Christian couples from Texas. One couple met on a mission to Haiti and are overseas again right now. My wife and I, Haruko, she's here, attended the 7-week course at Rabbi Jonathan Kahn's church in the fall of 2014, and it's designed to teach us how to build the foundation for preparedness lifestyle and peace through deeper understanding in our relationship with Christ. This course will cover planning, teamwork and community, food and water supplies, power supply, safe home, and grab-and-go bags, home security, and spiritual preparation. You'll learn to ready your heart for family and your home for what is to come. This information will change your life as it has mine. Some of the other courses may. This definitely will. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Neil. And Neil's class is also being offered online. Now I'd like to invite up my very own Unification Sanctuary President, Dr. Richard Panzer. Come on up.
Thank you. So who here would like to end personal and world poverty? Raise your hand. Okay. Anybody want to have personal, remain personally poor and, no, everyone wants. So this course actually, it's looking at the relationship between God-centered economics, which is based on the individual human freedom and responsibility, which is really emphasized in the new Constitution of Chonalguk. And I was thinking about this because, you know, some people think the way for poor people to get rich is by stealing it from rich people, right? No, many you know, you can see this being advocated. And so I was thinking, especially the Constitution really is talking a lot about what kind of system actually is the best system to help people to actually have access to developing their wealth, which is actually God wants everyone to be wealthy and prosperous and able to give, right? So we'll be looking at Milton Friedman's Free to Choose video series. It's excellent content on different systems and how they actually work, and also how free enterprise has actually lifted millions of people out of poverty, but how it also can be corrupted. And so it looks at that. And then also there's a book by Arthur Brooks, which is really good. He looks at economics from a value, a moral, biblical, and values perspective. So it's a great, it's a very good content. And even if you don't want to take it, I want to take it. So it's online.
Yeah. Yeah, his is online only.
We have refreshments.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Panzer. Next, I'd like to invite up our First Lady of the Church, Mrs. Yunanim. And her class is full, but I think it's important for everyone to know what it is that she's offering. Come on up, Yunanim.
Thank you. You know, I'm teaching about, I know nothing about the Bible. And, you know, when I offered this class last semester, some people said, oh, maybe that's not a very good title, you know. You got to know something about Bible teaching, you know. But I really like this title because, you know, we know, I know personally, there's so much barrier between us and the Bible. When we think about Bible, it's some kind of the book that we have to demonize, or, you know, we have to step over the Bible, and there's many preconceptions about Bible, but as you know, that Father loved the Bible. That was the only book he had. When he write down that the glory, the blessing of glory, that's the book based on, you know, his faith and his love for God. And, you know, as she said, at this time, my class is offering Korean, and the class is full now. But today I want to really emphasize the fact that, you know, please get close Bible to your life and draw God's word in your life, because you know what? That really changes my life, and it really brings you joy, you know, and the happiness that God designed for us to have, brothers and sisters. And, you know, next time, I really hope to see you in my class again, advertising it in advance. And thank you so much.
Thank you. Hers is Thursday mornings. Next is, on Friday, my class, More Than a Carpenter, is going to be offered both online and on location. And I'll never forget something that Pastor said this past summer. He said, you know, in the Unification Church, we were all taught about Jesus, but we weren't really taught to love Jesus. And that really stayed with me. And this class is going to be us learning how to love Jesus more deeply. And More Than a Carpenter is a wonderful book, which actually everybody receives when you fill out your connection card. And it's the story of a journey of someone who was a skeptic to someone who really became a devoted follower of Jesus Christ. And in the class, we're going to be taking scripture that we read in the book and doing journaling, reflecting on what the meaning it has for us in our lives. We're going to be singing songs of praise and worship together and just really together going on a journey to become closer to Jesus. So thank you. And last but not least, I'd like to invite up Greg and Elka Knoll, who are going to talk to us about the Maker's Diet.
All right. So, you know, we'll be examining in this class just how the body is such an amazing gift that God has given us. And the Bible talks about the body being the sacred temple. And we'll be examining also what has happened to this sacred temple. How has our food supply been tainted and really hijacked by Satan? And food now is filled with chemicals and additives, pesticides, all sorts of horrible things are happening to our animals at factory farms. We'll delve into that. And how you should start reading labels and the importance of doing such and how to get back to eating food that is created by God. And we'll also examine what kind of diseases are the result of this kind of toxic diet that has really emerged just in the past 80 years or so, how our food supply has been changed. And now we have rampant heart disease, we have rampant cancer, diabetes is spiking, strokes. This is really the result of our daily choices, the choices we make three times a day. So we'll be delving into that. And what kind of diet did God create for us? And we have a lot of, we're going to be focusing on the book that Dr. Furman wrote, Eat to Live, which is a real science-based medical doctor. He's a family practitioner, so he's rooted in the real world, but he has really uncovered so many helpful aspects on how we can change our food addiction. Really, we're all addicted to sugars, fats, like oils, and we're addicted to salt, a lot of things that are really damaging our internal organs, our blood, our pH balance. Things are really out of whack. So really, this course is about getting back into balance, bringing a lifestyle of balance back in. It's not extreme. It's really common sense kind of stuff. But it gives you the tools and encourages you and strengthens you to make tough decisions that now are tough. Before, they weren't tough because we weren't surrounded by all this kind of temptation every step of the way. And then we'll be, you know, so this is really a class about letting food be thy medicine. Let food heal oneself. And another important part of the course is what Elka will be doing. I don't know, would you like to say what you're going to be doing?
We're not going to be having snacks. We got to do some food demos, and everybody's invited to join in. We want to show it's that, you know, like how to get into the habit of making healthy food for yourself.
Yeah, so you'll be well fed if you join our classes, which is Saturday at 6 p.m. Thank you.
All right. Can we have one more round of applause for all of our leaders as they return back to your seats? Thank you so much. And just to remind you, if you didn't catch which class is on location, which class is online, everything is available on the Sanctuary Church website. And, you know, something like this is always more than the result of just one person's effort. So I just want to take a minute and really thank Jarmo Karjalainen and Herrick Schmidt, who actually designed the catalog, and Pierre Tardy for all their help in making HSU work. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Kerry. I want to thank Kerry one more time for organizing the new trimester coming up. You know, this is really exciting, the whole HSU, Holy Spirit University, because these are classes that come out of free association and free will. So, you know, the classes you saw today Everybody, all the facilitators created their syllabus, what they wanted to teach. They felt God is calling them. They have a special anointing to teach this. And it's not your standard, college brainwashing center. you got the five different classes and 101. No, these are really out of the expertise of people who have been living these things and these different, dimensions in their life. Right? So this is what's so wonderful about HSU is that it is really an expression of the freedom and responsibility of Chunigu. Right? And free association and all these wonderful riches that come when free peoples stand with God. Amen? Woo! I love it. All right. Next, please. Everyone is welcome for lunch. Thank you for all your wonderful potluck dishes and respecting adults at lunch on Sunday. Please do not take food into the small chapel or library. The food ministry team appreciate your help in providing enjoyable lunchtime for everyone. Let's give it a one time, everybody, for the food ministry team. Thank you, guys. Yes, no, that's in there. That's a secret coming up. And thank you, Lord. If it wasn't for this man, we wouldn't have streets to drive on, folks. This man, he was here hours before plowing all that plow work you saw. This man did it out of the goodness of his heart. He is a true, true saint and brother. Let's give it a one time for Brother Lowell. What a fantastic brother. Thank you, brother. Okay, and next, please. Today we have an anointing ceremony for the national leader of Austria today. Austria is standing up. Salvation is going to Austria. And we also have an anointing ceremony for the national leader of Thailand. So Thailand is rising up as well. Amen. Okay, next, please. Okay, that is it. Thank you, announcements team, and all the preparations. Let's give them one big round of applause. Kids, have fun in Sunday school. Okay? All right, there they go. See how much they will look forward to Sunday school? Okay? And I would like to invite Tim from the World Mission Department to give us a brief report. And also, I would then like to ask my wife to come up and speak. She hasn't spoken in a while. So I want her to come and speak. Okay, Tim. Let's give it a one time for Mr. Dr. Tim. No, are you a doctor? He's not a doctor. Tim Elder.
Thank you very much. Is this a good place for me to stand? Thank you. I wanted to give a report on the upcoming blessing because, as we've been mentioning, in February 2013, something happened that we didn't know until later. That is in February 2013, all of us who participated in the Foundation Day blessing at that time, the Foundation Day ceremonies at that time, thought that we were participating in a ceremony that was under the supervision and control of our true father, but we realize now that it was under the supervision and control of the other guy, of Satan. So we needed to correct that mistake. Sometimes you make mistakes, you got to correct them. And God gives us the grace that He forgives us, and He gives us the chance to do that and then to move on. And so that's what we've been doing since April of last year. And we've had the April 21st blessing, we had the August 30th blessing, and now we have the upcoming one on February 13th. And we've been doing blessings, one at a time, two at a time, three at a time, here in Sanctuary Church all along. When people come here and they say, okay, I want to be blessed today, we can do it. And we've been doing that. And also in Asia and in Europe and in South America and Africa, these have been going on. For the February 13th blessing, hi there, we count blessings that were performed after August 30th towards the February 13th blessing. And so these have been going on. So I wanted to report today how many have been done since August 30th. And as I add up the ones that have been reported to us, and not all are reported to us, and they don't have to be reported to us, but the ones that have been reported to us are 900. She's going to come again? No? Okay. 960. And they've been happening in Korea and Japan, of course, and in Thailand, Philippines, Spain, Panama, Russia, Kenya, Australia, South Africa, and Peru. And if your country's not in here, please, if you want it to be reported, you can email me. But we send out blessing kits, and we let people multiply those blessing kits so that they can share it with their relatives or friends or members of their tribal Messiah mission. And we ask those people to register on our website, the website that you saw just a moment ago. But that's not compulsory. God knows, and Spirit world knows who's in what position, and that's what's important. So these numbers are a very conservative figure. But things are going on, especially recently in Japan. There was a blessing of 89 people, 89 couples, I'm sorry, 89 couples, more than that number in terms of number of people. And these were people who, over the years, had decided to be arm's length from the church. And in fact, even in this blessing, they didn't want any Japanese leader to come and help them. They wanted to have someone from Korea come and help them. And so Reverend Sang-Yeol Lee from Korea went and did a blessing in Japan. And that's fine, because people are free in the way that they choose to relate to True Father and to the Second King. And there are many, many ways that they can do that. They can do that through an organization. More than one organization. We have four organizations, at least right now, in Japan. I'm not sure if these new 89 are an organization or not. I don't think they are. But aside from that, we have four. And in most other countries, we have one. Or people relate to us individually. And that's fine, too. I don't want to be a part of the organization that's in my country. I want to send my tithes and donations directly to Sanctuary Church. That's fine, too. So our objective is to disperse a power and authority as much as possible. We don't want to create another centralized power structure. Amen. Do we want that? Yeah. No. We don't want centralized power structures. For one thing, centralized power structures always bring corruption. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. If it's absolutely centralized, it's absolutely corrupt.
There are absolutes.
Yes. And so we don't even have a membership role. We have a list of people who have donated, and that's the closest thing we come to a membership role. But people relate, but we are, as our pastor, as our king has been emphasizing, we are not about religion. We are about a relationship. A relationship between each family, each individual, and God. And the function of the church is to facilitate that relationship, to serve people so that they can develop that relationship and become closer to God. And we hope that this happens during the up and through the upcoming blessing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tim. And Amaya, she has a wonderful testimony. I want her to share. Amaya.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. I hope you had no problem coming to church today, because yesterday the snow was pretty severe, right? I don't know, I agree with him about the spring opinion. So I saw, I coming up to church, I saw a car that is totally like upside down on the street. So I was like, oh, my heart kind of sank. So I kind of pray for them while I'm coming up here. And I hope, you know, anybody who got into accident or anything happened to them because of the snowstorm, and I send my prayer for them too. Today, my husband, he want me to share about testimony about the praise and worship. So that's why I came. It's not, you know, regular, you know, the thing that I come up before him, but I want to share about why we want to praise and worship, even though we don't feel like sometimes. That's I had a small testimony, so he wanted me to share it, so I came out here. You know, when I came to when our family came to Pennsylvania, I really experienced the very bottom of my life. I feel like nobody's really understand us, and we are totally kicked out from Korea, and then palace, and then we have no community. I know people will speak bad about us, framing us, and all that. And I really feel like I'm like David when he was in the lowest time of his life, when he's in the Gislag's cave. He lost his general position. He lost his wife. Saul, King Saul, is constantly trying to kill him. And then he had to pretend he's crazy because to spare his life from his enemy. So I really felt the lowest of my my life. I was, and at the same time, I feel like crazy busy to take care of my five children. They have to go to school, make a lunch, and all that, you know, that we have to do regularly to keep up our life. And I was so busy. And then I can see myself sinking more and more and more to the bottom and becoming more negative, and more negative. And I realized, you know what? I cannot do this anymore. And I surrendered. You know what? I cannot overcome this with my power. But I know one power that can overcome this. That was God. Right? That was our Christ. That's our Christ. So I really relied on my strength, on our Father. But how? You know, would I pray all day long without abandoning all my responsibility as a mother and wife and a pastor's wife? But I realized one thing all the time I do, while I'm driving, while I'm doing dishwashing, while I'm doing laundry, only thing I can do all the time is praise worship. So I decide to do praise worship all the time. I mean, literally all the time. So I even like wrote down I print out all this lyric of my favorite praise worship song, and I stick it on the kitchen cabinet in the laundry room, and whenever I feel like I'm gonna think about negative and then this disaster and then end of my life, whatever I get into, I start to sing a praise and worship song. You know what? I'm going to trade my sorrow to the joy of the Lord. Amen. Declare it. You know what? Right now, this is like the lowest bottom of my life, but I know the morning will come, and I will celebrate His glory again. So that's been my life. And a couple of weeks ago, while we were doing praise worship service, it was a family worship day, so all the our children and every the Sunday school children were staying in the sanctuary. And my 9 years old and then my 11 years old boy is standing right next to me while I'm doing praise worship. I tried to get into it, but they're like constantly bumping me, and then they're constantly talking to me, "Mommy, when it's gonna end?" They're constantly asking me, "Oh, please help me, honey. It's not a time to talk. You do praise worship too," but they're constantly giving me feedback. "Oh, mommy, that person looks funny," and whatever they want to say. And then right behind me, our lovely brother, our Robert, is helping me great to get into praise worship too, because, you know, he was once in a choir, and then his choir, the head of the choir, came to him and, "Robert, you sing like a bird." And then Robert said, "Oh, really? I never heard of that." "Yes, you sing like a butcher."
A vulture.
So think about it in my perspective. I still love you, brother, okay? Even though you can't see it. That's not the criteria for God's love either. So, you know, think about it in my perspective. Here's my two boys constantly, you know, nagging and driving me down. And right behind me, Robert's singing.
Not really. Oh my gosh, I really did not feel like praise and worship. Praise and worship did not come out of my heart. But you know what? I still did a praise and worship. Because I know there's a power that even though I don't feel like a praise and worship, it's not my emotion, it's not my circumstance that determines my relationship with God. But His word is so good. His love is so good because He is so good. That's why I praise worship Him. You know, my husband asked me to share this another story, so I'm going to spend a little more time. But, you know, I'm a type of person that is, it's like, how to say, it's like a glass. You can tell what I'm thinking. I'm a mile away. So I can't really hide things so well. And if you know me, it's very hard for me to say that, oh, God spoke to me. God spoke to me this. You know what? God told me to do this. You know, saying this is very uncomfortable for me because I saw so many people misuse that. I saw so many people who justify using that word to meet their end. So I was like, I kind of hysterically didn't like that, you know, phrase. Oh, God told me. I heard God's voice. But you know what? After I really realized from Pastor's sermon that, you know, listening to God's word is not about, you know, doing the power trip and then doing the ego boost. It's not about that. It's about, wow, God's word is this great. And then God's word make me really humble, make me a better person. When nobody can remind me how selfish I was, how egoistic I was, He reminds me. He hits my conscience constantly. That is what God can talk to me. Think about it. If we are truly sons and daughters of God, if we are truly bride of Christ and body of God, then are we supposed to listen to Him directly instead of channeling some kind of spiritual medium? Why do we need a spiritual medium or go somewhere else to get God's message? See how strange it became? And then you know what? I heard God's voice. And I can say that with no shame because I know His word is there to not to, you know, make myself claim I'm the next spiritual medium. And don't worry about it. I'm not going to do that. And you can check on me. But it's there to make me humble and make Him love more. See how great and exciting it can be? I'm just, wow, it's amazing how amazing it can be. And I really hope that you can feel the joy and the happiness that I'm feeling from God's word. And one night, okay, enough introduction, right? Okay, I'm going to tell you what God told me. One night, it was at 3 o'clock in a.m. And all of a sudden, I woke up. And I was like, oh, I woke up and I couldn't go to sleep. And then I heard God's voice. And then He told me that, look at your closet. Okay. Look at my closet at 3 a.m. And He said, look at your closet and how messy it is. That's what He told me. So I'm like, oh, God, I know my closet is messy, so I'm planning to clean it up. And I'm talking to God. And then He told me something further. He told me that, think about your spiritual life. Is your spiritual life is that messy? Clean it up. Clean it up, your spiritual life. Just like as you clean it up your closet. If you don't clean it up, it will the sin and the bad thing will pile it up. And then you won't even able to find where I am. So I realized that. And then that day, I started to clean it up. And as I clean it up, guess what I did? I did a praise and worship too. I was singing, I was celebrating, and then I don't, Yeah, I'm going to be honest. I'm not a very good person to organize and making it clean and things like that. But, you know, that day I was really enjoying it. Because I know that, you know, when we even clean up our spiritual life, He's going to perfectly show our way. Because He's our salvation. He's the everlasting life. He's the water that we can draw salvation and life and truth from, sister, brothers. It truly is. And when we really know that His voice, He's our shepherd, and we can hear, we are like His sheep. And if we really make the antenna to listen to Him, then we can hear Him. We will know His voice, we'll recognize His voice from the other voice, brothers and sisters. And let us praise worship, because He deserves that, all that grace. And thank you.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Amma. That was beautiful, thank you. You know, it's so important, I think, you know, what she was talking about, because just right into here, light overcomes darkness. Light overcomes darkness. But let's go to 2 Timothy, and let's read this together. From verse 6, let's read this together. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Also translated as a disciplined mind. 8. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner. This is when Paul is in prison. But be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God, who hath saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began, but is now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who hath abolished death and hath brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Amen. Amen. Woo. The word is so powerful. You know, this is such an important scripture, and I just want to bring your attention to 2 Timothy here. This is chapter 1, verse 7. And it says, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear. That's really important, because in this day, right, in this day where we are experiencing the start of the tribulation and the, you know, worldwide collapse, I have some statistics here, but we see, for example, we know that of the year of the Shemitah, and of course the post-year Shemitah is where we see a lot of the wars happen, particularly in the Middle East. But what's interesting, there's the analysts have been doing economic analysis, and what they see in about the first 3 weeks of 2016, there's been 2 emergency market shutdowns in China within the first 4 trading days. The Dow Jones Industrial Average has been at the lowest point in history within the first 3 weeks. It's never lost this many points within the first 3 weeks of a year. So even in the crashes we had in 2008 and 2001, the stocks were better than they were doing now. Overall, $15 trillion of global stock market wealth has been wiped out since last June. That is 1/5 of the global economy, okay? The stock economy is gone, wiped out, bye-bye. So massive economic collapse, massive economic wealth being wiped out. Also, another key indicator for economic activity is what is known as the Baltic Dry Index. That is the index of freight and harbor freight carriers worldwide. Okay, the Baltic Dry Index just hit another all-time record low. So this shows, of course, how healthy economic trading is going on in the world, right? How healthy things are going, how healthy shipping trade, how healthy buying and selling is going. It is at the record all-time low. Big conglomerates announcing huge shutdowns, like Walmart announcing they will shut down 269 stores worldwide in the first 3 weeks of this year. And jobless claims or unemployment surging to the highest level in 6 months in the United States. So just a couple statistics. They also mentioned what something I heard for the first time, which is called the South Korean Shipping Index. I never heard of that, but apparently that's the shipping index of the health of trade in East Asia between China, Japan, you know, Korea's right in that peninsula region. That is down 13.8% at an all-time low. So we see the world economy is struggling, okay? And we had the major crash in 2008. That was already predicted by the Shemitah. 2001, predicted by the Shemitah, okay? God's biblical calendar comes around again. It ended 2015, but the next year is where we see this kind of collapse. Like right in the beginning of the year. Remember, folks, when you study sociology, there's a direct correlation, direct, to economic collapse, raising unemployment, right? Unemployment rises. Then there's a direct correlation with rising unemployment and two main things. Violent crime is absolutely scientifically correlated with rising unemployment. And suicide rates are also connected with rising unemployment. So we are now in a historical period, really, literally, where we see this kind of economic collapse. This is exactly what we've been telling you for the last 3 years. Those of you who know us and talk to us, right? And we've been saying this now for over a year online. At first, people think you're screaming at us, you're crazy, you know, you're nuts, you know, he's out there, and what is it? What do they call it? The naked prince of the wilderness or whatever. But we got now our Wilderness King t-shirts. Okay. But, you know, all that kind of insanity happening. And in 2012, nobody really thought anything was going to happen. Nobody really thought the world would start collapsing. It was still looking okay. Now we can start feeling it. You can start seeing it. Any city you go to, you see businesses closing down, etc. You see the actual repercussions of the start of the fade away, the collapse. Right? Some of the top analysts say that this one will be felt by the normal person because now it's at the international level and now it's at the global bear market, right? Not just a national bear market, a global bear market, which cannot be bailed out, right? Massive wealth loss, massive, massive. At the same time, we see exactly what Satan wants to do, which is what? Create a world government, a world body, centralized world power, which will rule over human beings, right? Totally pushed by the fallen satanic UN. Father called the UN, satanic UN. It was Cain-type UN. That's why he made the Abel-type UN. Totally opposite, right? You can even see centralized religions like the Pope. Yeah, the Pope, totally supporting it. Right? And of course, all these things with climate change and all these things, this is just simply different fake information agendas. For what? The real thing is money, right? It's money. The real thing is to put taxes on people worldwide, right? For emitting carbon dioxide. You greedy human beings are breathing, so you should be taxed, right? This is the concept of the elites, right? So we see this now overwhelming the world. We see it being pushed. And we see that the tribulation is really happening. What's interesting about this time is that this word is, I think, very important in this time. Because in the time of tribulation is fear, it's fearful, right? It's very unpredictable. We don't know what to expect, right? Our wealth could be wiped away if we saved up all our lives, but then all of a sudden it could be wiped away in a day. Right, things that you have no control over, like in Europe. Look at Europe, how just radical Muslims are being able to pour into Europe. Right, not all the refugees are radicals, but we know that there's a population, upwards of, it could be even up to 10% who are radical. Wahhabi, Saudi-backed Muslims, right? We've studied the history of the Crusades last week, and we saw the comparative to the trans-Saharan the Muslim slave trade. See how radically different it was. Okay? And so radically different from the message we're constantly given that Christianity is evil and everything else is good. Amen. Amen. So this is what's so important at this time. There's a lot of fear that can be in the atmosphere. There's a lot of fear. But one thing we have to see is fear, number one, it's a spirit, right? He said God hath not given us a spirit of fear. It's a spirit. And also God hath not given to us, so who gives us the spirit of fear? Satan. Satan gives us the spirit of fear. So if we choose to give and take with the spirit of fear, we are saying, Satan, possess me. Right? We're saying, Satan, possess me. Possess me, devil. Take control of me. Use me for your purpose. That's what possess means. Like, what does possess mean? It means to own, right? Right? I possess this shamag, right? I own this shamag. I don't, but this is probably my boys. I don't know what you put in. All right, so possessing, and when we accept the spirit of fear, Satan, we are agreeing with Satan possessing us. This is very important at this time, because look at, even the macrocosm is falling away. The macrocosm is just as Father predicted if Mother turned her back on him. We can even see in the fallen four-position foundation they're creating and the only begotten daughter theology. She is now openly in multiple speeches. You've seen them. Claiming that the 2,000 years of Christian history are for the returning Lord of the Second Advent, the only begotten daughter. Okay? This is not only the greatest heresy. What is it? What is it really? It's teaching theological lesbianism. The bridegroom is coming. So the bridegroom comes as a woman without a seed. Without the spermata in the Greek, right? The spermata, the seed of God. And all the brides have to wed her. So then it's becoming theological lesbianism. And then the husbands have to become bisexual. So all the family-fed husbands also have to become bi, because they have to allow their wife to have intimacy with a female only begotten daughter. So you have literally the triad of Satan being created. The most wicked system you can create is being created before our eyes. Right? And this is dangerous, dangerous. If you put your soul in the midst of this, you are bound for destruction. It is so obviously against God and against the purpose of creation, against marriage, against the four-person foundation. And that's why the Lord is second return, because when he returns, he brings the lineage of God. What's so amazing about the three-day ceremony and the blessing, and we've talked about it many times, but what it does, it totally clarifies that which is not clarified in 2,000 years of Christian theology. Because in Christian theology, everybody knows that when the Lord returns, the three main identities of Christ is bridegroom, judge, and king. Three main identities. Okay? So the whole, but we are supposed to be as brides. Christ is coming back for us brides. Okay, because we have the parable of the virgins, plural, brides. But at the same time, for 2,000 years of Christian history, it's been the common understanding that the bride of Christ is like the church. So we're all really the bride. What kind of gender, identity, and sexual ambiguation does that create? You will see, because if I'm a man, for example, I'll give you a real example. If you are a priest in a Catholic tradition, you are actually marrying Christ. That is your vow. So if you are a man and your bridegroom, your marriage partner, is a man, you have serious problems, which are unspoken about in the Christian world. It's just kind of glazed over. Let's kind of just not talk about that. But then that's why you have so much rampant homosexuality. In the Catholic Church, you have pedophilia. Even in the Protestant movements, you have ministers who become confused about their own sexual identity, become gay, right? Because their primary identity is relating to Christ as a bride. Do you see how much confusion that can bring? And it has throughout time. That's why when Father released the blessing and released the three-day ceremony, we didn't know what we were receiving. It was the absolute clarification of the positions in relation to God. What is the bride of Christ? Well, the three-day ceremony shows very clearly. It is the woman now who is becoming married, blessed under the covenant of God. She goes from being a fallen Eve to a bride of Christ, or a restored Eve. So the woman stays in the position of the bride, which is normal, and bride is usually a woman. Unless you're in crazy town USA, like now, right? Or in Babylonia or Assyria. Right? Bride means what? Female. Right? So the wife is standing in the position of the bride of Christ. The husband is what? He goes from the fallen archangel position to the Son of God position. So a son of God. What is a son? Right? I have fathers above me, I'm his son. What is a son? A son is what? It's a vessel. It's a body birthed from the father's what? Seed. Also, the son holds what? He holds the father's seed. He holds the father's seed. So the husband goes from being a fallen archangel who raped the seed, who stole and planted a fallen seed, and the husband goes to what? He goes to one now who is a son of God, which is holding the seed of God. Do you see what I mean? Then, through that union between the body, and so that's why it's the body of Christ, the body of God. The husband becomes the body of God, holding the lineage of God. And the wife becomes a bride of Christ, whom through the husband, God can love. It's so clear principle. It's so clear principle. It completely is consonant with everything Father taught about absolute sex, the covenant of marriage, etc. Holy fidelity, holy sexuality, and marriage. Right? And before one is wed, because one is not a bride or a husband yet, before one is, you know, wed, if you're like the single young people here, they are sons and daughters of God. So do you see how that happens? So the positions are very clear. There's no sexual ambiguity. There's no weird relationships that we're supposed to kind of, oh, that's kind of weird, but I guess I'm, okay, I'm supposed to be a bride of Christ. I'm a man. I'm a gun-toting man. I'm a fighting man, and I'm supposed to be a bride to, you know, right? That gives me some major problems. That's why you see this kind of rampant homosexuality that's hidden underneath the veil of the Christian world. So there has to be that clarification. All those positions must be clarified. Otherwise, we will have Christianity becoming like a vessel for holding this secret undercurrent of homosexuality, which is, of course, an abomination before God. Do you see how powerful the blessing is and how powerful the three-day ceremony is? It is the total clarification of the history of prophecy. You see? It's very interesting because when we look at how the providence is moving, how it's moving on the macro and microcosm, we see there's a real correlation. The stronger we fight against the tyrants and the hierarchy and the false, illegitimate structure, you also see a correlation in the real world with people who are in the Protestant Christian field who are starting to raise their voices too. It's very interesting. You have people all of a sudden jump out like Trump, and all of a sudden, people that, you know, come out of the woodwork. Because, folks, it's very important for us to realize it is not the radical forms of Islam that will come in and bring a new civilization of goodness. Just like the regressive left fascists are always saying, because they hate Christianity. Especially Protestant Christianity. They love Catholicism. They love centralized, any religion that's centralized, but they hate Protestant Christianity, evangelical Christianity. Why? Because it's totally decentralized. It is a radical faith because it's so decentralized. And it is the only faith. It is the only faith that has been able to produce the real freedom we experienced the last 200 years on this planet. Because that freedom that we experienced was what? Localized government. Decentralized hierarchies. Where does that come from? What root and system does that come from? It comes from the Protestant tradition of direct relating to God. It doesn't come from Catholicism. It doesn't come from Islam. Islam always has created sultanates, harems, total fascist states, totalitarian states. Catholicism has always supported fascist dictators. They even supported Hitler because they themselves are a centralized power, which is the reason why they're supporting world government today. Totally on the Satan side. Not trying to free people and bring freedom to the world. Right? It's only Protestant evangelical Christianity, but look how much it is hated by the West and by the left. There's a bombardment every single day that evangelical Christianity is insane, it's crazy, it's too rebellious, it doesn't follow the, you know, this or that plans, it's too awkward to manage. That's why, folks, it creates the base of freedom. You cannot control something that decentralized in one head. This is so important for us to understand because as we are in a time of great collapse, we could see people's wealth being wiped out, things that you've saved up in banks disappearing. We can see that literally in our lifetime, right? Many economic analysts are saying this crash will be worse than the Depression. So it'll be felt by the normal man and woman. Now over 51% of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. Did you know that? New statistics just out. The middle class has now in America fallen below the majority. The middle class is now the minority. It's at now 49%. It's never been at 49%. Never, never been at 49% in the history of America. So we are seeing a decline. We are seeing not good days ahead. That being said, we can feel overwhelmed. We can receive the spirit of fear. But one thing that's very important about understanding things about the tribulation is that tribulation is the harbinger for the glory of God. Okay? So there is a tribulation. Yes, Christians are beheaded. People who believe and profess faith are persecuted. Yes, that's true. But it doesn't go on forever. Yes, they're assaulted. Yes, they're called racist. Yes, they're called bigots. Yes, they're discriminated against. But it doesn't last forever. And that tribulation creates the place where the Lord returns. Where the glory of God comes, and by force, by authority, and by power, wipes away the false authority of Satan. That is so important for us to understand this time, folks, because we can be gloom and doom and whoa, it's going to be all downhill, it's going to collapse everything, you know, and all hell is going to break loose, violent crime, homicide rates, suicide rates. I'm not saying don't be prepared. Be prepared. Amen. Right? Be prepared. But we cannot be paralyzed with the spirit of fear. We don't want to receive that spirit. We know this is already prophesied. We know tribulation will come. It is a sign of the return of Christ, right? Of His glory returning, His kingdom coming. It's interesting even in a small community, some of the young people have been receiving revelation, and like I shared with some of you today. You know, the Bible says when the real rapture happens after tribulation, when we're taken up in the clouds, etc., and Christ is there, and He has on His thigh is written King of Kings. Right? That's kind of weird. Why would it be written on His thigh? That's kind of weird. Right? This is a very weird thing. Like, why is it written on His thigh? His identity, the King of Kings, is written on His thigh. And one young man here, I don't know if John is here today. Yeah, he had a revelation, which is the inner thigh. Because what is the inner thigh close to? It is close to the seed of God. In the Greek, spermata, which of course is where we get the English word sperm. And what is the seed of God? The sperm is spermata is a living, it's a living organism, right? We're taught to see it as such a disgusting thing, but it's living information, it's a living organism. It holds information. It holds the identity of that father, right? Do you see that? You see how, and it's written, or that identity is on the thigh. And it's so interesting because John said, well, Cook John called me this week, and he said, look at the picture that we're using with Father, in the white. Right here we have Father in the white robe, right? And on His thigh are written the signatures of the three kingships. You could not have planned that. That was unbelievable when he told me this week. I said, wow, my gosh, that's right. It's written on His thigh. It was so unbelievably bizarre. I mean, how can you plan that? We just didn't want to write it on Father's face or something, you know, on His chest or something. It just ended up being written on His thigh. So it was the three kingships that Father Himself set up and from which the constitution of Chenigu comes out. Which is a truly free, freedom and responsible based system. It is a true free market system. It is a true place where people can live in the gifts that God has given, right? And so all these kind of things, and I just feel that in this time, yes, we can focus on the realities of the world, which are not good, and they only get worse, it's true. Yes, persecution will rise. Yes, okay, that's true. Yeah, right? Yes, radicalism and radical Wahhabi Islam is rising. Yes, that's true. Yes, there is a class of civilizations coming. That's true. We see it in Europe already. Okay, all those things are true. But at the same time, let us not forget, which is also coming, which is the glory, which is the kingdom that is also coming. Because, folks, it has to sometimes get worse before it gets better. Sometimes it has to get worse before it gets better. So I want to focus on that today. But look at this quote by Father when he was in prison. This was in Hungnam prison, in the torture camp there. And he said, when I went to prison and manacles were placed on my wrist, they could not restrain me because I had love. When I was in cramped positions that made it hard to sleep, I woke up at night to see light shining from my hands. Why was there light? It was because God was embracing me. I discovered his love. That is why light could shine even in that dark room. My God is a God of love. And that brings us right back here. Christ, who has abolished death, brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. You know, so folks, when we are praising God, you know, I want to really draw your attention. Because when we're praising God, it's like we're entering a supernatural place. A place which is separated from this world. It's almost like we can enter into a supernatural realm. And in that realm, we can commune and relate with God. And it may sound crazy to sing and be glad when you're in persecution, but the scripture says that, right? Yes, be of good cheer. Amen. Be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. In tribulation is the time for real believers and sons and daughters of God to find their joy in the strength of God. Right? It's so critical. It may seem crazy that all the whole world is collapsing. Hey, what, even if it collapses more, we still have to be praising God. We still have to be singing songs of praise, because those songs are not just songs. They are our soul crying out in the darkness for God. Amen. So when we are singing and praising God today, SOS was not able to practice this week because of the with the live music, because of the snow days and the snow that we had. So we have some wonderful videos prepared, but I have this wonderful song that I want to meditate with you all on in the praise and worship time, and it's called "The King of My Heart." It's so beautiful. Before we do that, I'd like to ask Lisa to come up today. She will be doing a praise painting today. Come on, Lisa, come on up. Bring your Hunter's Bible. She got her camo Bible. And look at this. She's sporting the bling bling car arms, bling bling. That's a K-type. Remember K-type? That's a K-type gene strategy. Not an R-type. Okay? So she got her bling bling, K-type bling bling going on. Amen. Okay, so let's spin this around so she get her rima. Okay, let's spin it around so she doesn't know where to go. All right, and there, take your rima, Lisa. Go, quick, get your rima. Okay, turn it wherever you go. Quick.
Judges,
okay?
Okay.
And right here. You want to read that, or should I read it? Then the woman went and told her husband, "A man of God came to me. He looked like the awe-inspiring angel of God. I didn't ask him where he came from, and he didn't tell me where he came from, or he didn't tell me his name. He said to me, 'You will conceive and give birth to a son. Therefore, do not drink wine or beer, and do not eat anything unclean, because a boy will be a Nazarite to God from birth until the day of his death.'" Amen. Woo! Whoa! God gave you something today, Lisa. So let the Spirit guide you. Please go on up there. Let the Spirit guide you. I'd like to ask SOS to come up today. Even though they didn't practice, it's okay. We just want to sing with everybody and meditate on God in the supernatural realm in the Spirit. remember, just let the Spirit guide you on how to express that beautiful scripture. All right, everybody, I'd like to, everybody, to please stand up. Let's take this time to meditate on God's word. I want to read from Joel chapter 2 real quick.
Let the king of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from, always.
Let's meditate on this.
And let the king of my heart be the shadow where I hide. The ransom for my life, oh, is my song. Yes, you are good, you're good. Oh, you are good, you're good.
Yes, Lord, we worship you.
You're never gonna let me
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Second chapter of Joel, the scripture says, blow the trumpet in Zion, sound the alarm on my holy hill, let all who live in the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming, it is close at hand, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and blackness. Like dawn spreading across the mountains, a large and mighty army comes, such as never was in ancient times, nor ever will be in ages to come. Before them fire devours, behind them a flame blazes. Before them the land is like the Garden of Eden, behind them a desert waste. Nothing escapes them. They have the appearance of horses. They gallop along like cavalry. With a noise like that of chariots, they leap over the mountaintops. Like a crackling fire consuming stubble. Like a mighty army drawn up for battle. At the sight of them, nations are in anguish. Every face turns pale. They charge like warriors. They scale walls like soldiers. They all march in line, not swerving from their course. They do not jostle each other. Each marches straight ahead. They plunge through defenses without breaking ranks. They rush upon the city. They run along the walls. They climb into the houses like thieves. They enter through the windows. Before them, the earth shakes. The heavens tremble. The sun and moon are darkened, and the stars no longer shine. The Lord thunders at the head of his army. His forces are beyond number. And mighty is the army that obeys his command. The day of the Lord is great. It is dreadful. Who can endure it? Amen. Amen. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Peace, peace upon these people. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, yes, Lord. We worship you this day. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, we worship you. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, yes, Lord. We worship you, we worship you this day. We worship you this day. Yes, Father, yes, Father, yes, Father, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Let us not be singers of praise. Let us be psalmists of praise. Psalmists must go before the armies to sing the national anthems of God. The psalmist must go before the war to prepare the troops for battle. Let us not be singers of praise, but psalmists of praise. Let us stand with the warriors that risk their lives to protect God, His blood, His kingship, and His kingdom. Father, give us a strength in these times where we may be overcome with fear and dread.
It's not in your nature,
where we may be overcome by the spirit of fear.
It's not in your nature.
Father, we ask that you would strengthen us.
And you never will.
Let us know your true
it's not in your nature.
Let us know that you are perfect peace. You are perfect love, perfect righteousness, perfect sinlessness, perfect goodness.
You're never gonna let us down.
Perfect compassion, perfect in all your ways.
Somebody needs confidence this morning that he'll never let you.
Father, we need you not in religion but in relationship.
He's been God a long time.
If we have Christ,
he knows what he's doing.
We have peace.
He knows
we have the way.
What he's doing in you.
We have truth. We have
when
righteousness. We have love.
When you don't believe it, he knows.
God,
he
we
knows.
Want to lift our hearts up to you today.
He knows and he doesn't fall off of his throne.
Yes, Lord.
He doesn't fall off of his throne. He
yes,
doesn't
Lord.
Fall off of his throne.
Yes,
no, and he never will.
Yes,
he doesn't fall off of his throne.
Yes,
he doesn't fall off of his throne.
Yes, Lord.
And he never will.
Yes,
oh, declare it this morning.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
No.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. His throne is strong. His throne has authority and righteousness and purity and power and holiness and love. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Overwhelm the thing that is overwhelming us today. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, Father, yes, Father. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. We worship you this day. We lift you, Father, in this day, in this place, in this sanctuary. God, we want to draw close to you. In the time of trouble, in the time of tribulation, in the time of challenge and strife, God, we want to move close to you. We want to draw near to you. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Guide us through these troubled times. Bring a new season this day. Let your people persevere through the tribulations ahead and not live in the spirit of fear. To not be possessed by the hand of Satan,
which tries to paralyze us and tries to leave us in the wake of immorality and death. But God, fill us not with the spirit of fear. The Bible says you have given us power and love and disciplined minds. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. We need your anointing this day. Yes, Father, we need you anointing us today. Lift our burdens of fear. Lift our burdens of anxiety. And let us stand in your powerful presence. Your powerful presence. Your powerful presence. Your powerful presence, God. Let us enter the supernatural realm where there is no fear, where there is no weakness, where there is power and might, love, and the gifts of the Spirit. Father, we thank you. God's so good, come on, sing it. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. Yes, God, yes, God. God's so good.
God, you're so good.
We join the voices of hundreds of years.
God, you're so good.
God is good.
God is so good. He is so good to me.
Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Let us stay in the presence of God. Let's stay in peaceful. That safe place.
Unreserved and unrestrained.
There's a place where God is.
Your love is wild.
The safest place is in some city or some other nation.
So our response.
The safest place to be is in the will of God. In the
your love is
of
wild.
God.
It's wild for me.
In the Spirit of God.
You unravel me with a melody.
Yes, God.
And you surround me with a song
of deliverance.
Of deliverance from my enemies.
All my fears.
Till all my fears are gone.
Are gone.
Now I'm no longer.
Yes, God, yes, God.
I am a child of God.
No longer a slave.
No, I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child.
Father, we want you to rejoice.
From my mother's womb, you were chosen.
From my father's seed,
love has called my name.
I've been born again.
And I've been born again into a family.
Your blood, your blood.
The blood flows through.
Through my veins. Why? That my father's seed.
You have chosen me.
You've chosen me.
Love
has called my name. I've been born again.
And I've been born again.
To a true family.
Family.
Where your true blood.
Your blood flows.
veins.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Now I'm no longer
a slave to fear. Yes, God, yes, God. We are in the presence of our Father.
No, I'm no longer.
Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Hallelujah.
I am a child of God.
Yes, God, yes.
No, I'm no longer slave to fear.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. I'm no longer,
I'm no longer a slave.
Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God.
I am a child of God.
Yes, God, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Sons and daughters, brides and body of God.
There's a song rising.
Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
We're the sons and the daughters of a good, good Father.
You are good. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. We live in your presence, Father. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Confident sons and daughters. In front of our Father. Competent sons and daughters. I am competent in Christ. I have all that I need to fight the battle and the good fight. All the weapons of warfare and spiritual armor I have in Christ, who makes me strong and who makes me stand against unrighteousness. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. My fears are drowned. Violently drown.
You rescued me so I could stand and say, I am a child of God.
I am a child of God.
You split the sea
so I can walk right through it.
My fears are drowned.
My fears die, die in your perfect love. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God.
Of God.
The demonic hierarchies that try to enslave and make slaves of the children of God, we come against you by the name of Jesus, where every knee will bow and tongue confess that he is a king and you are the servant, devil. You will sit down in the presence of God's children and his army of blood, bought by the blood, saved by the blood,
the word says that the earth
redeemed by the blood.
To realize who
that army shall overtake you, devil, and all your false hierarchies.
A song of sons and daughters singing to
you will crumble. Like Babylon
in fire and destruction. And the Spirit of God shall pour out holy fire upon all flesh, so that we may live in the kingdom that is coming. Cry.
Presence, God, when we empty ourselves before the King.
Who am I that the eyes that see my sin,
yes, God, yes, God, yes,
would look
God
on me with love,
yes, God,
and
yes,
watch
God
me rise,
yes,
again?
God, yes, God.
Who am I that the voice that calmed the sea,
yes, Lord, yes, Lord,
would call out through the rain? Calm the storm in,
yes, God,
me,
yes, God, yes, God.
Not because of who I am,
yes,
but because,
yes,
of what you've done,
yes, God.
Not because of what I've done,
yes, God,
but because of who you are. I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow, a wave tossed
of a
vapor in the wind. Still you hear me when I'm calling, Lord, you catch me,
yes,
when I'm,
yes,
falling,
God.
And you told me who I am,
yes,
I am yours,
yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
because of who I am, not because of me,
but because of what you've done,
because of the blood,
not because of what I've done,
never,
but because of who you are.
Yes, God, yes, God.
I am a flower quickly fading.
Yet again,
gone tomorrow.
Away.
A wave tossed in the ocean.
A vapor in the wind.
Vapor in the wind. Still you hear me when I'm calling. Lord, you catch me when I'm falling. You told me who I am.
Spirit is guiding our praise psalmists and praise painters to show the power of the Word of God, the living Word. And I really want to focus in on the lyrics of this song. The King inside my heart, the King in my heart, the mountain, the fountain.
Be the fountain I drink from, always in my soul.
Yes, God.
And let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide.
Yes,
the ransom for my life.
Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God.
Yes, you are good.
You're good, you're good.
You're good.
Father, we thank you for all the good goodness. You are a living God. Yes, God. You are the King in my heart. Yes, God, yes, God. Where I run,
the fountain I drink from,
the wells of salvation.
Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide.
Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
My song is you are good.
God, yes, God.
Oh,
we meditate on your goodness today. God, we do not want emotionalism, and we want to go beyond the music to dwell in your presence. The King. Yes, God. The anchor in the waves. Yes, God, yes, God.
Let the King of my heart be
the fire inside my veins. Oh, he is my song. King of my heart. The wind inside my, the anchor. He grounds me.
And let the King
in my veins. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. He's good, he's good, he's good. He's good, he's good, he's good. Yes, God, 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 yes, God. God hath not given us a spirit of fear, but he hath given us a spirit of power, of love and a sound mind.
You're never gonna let me down.
Yes, God, yes, God.
You're never gonna let me down.
Let us soar in your presence, God.
You're never gonna
in the supernatural realm. Beyond time and space. Beyond this world and the next, the true life and the presence of the King of Kings. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. We worship you this day. We worship you, God. We're free from all hierarchies of the devil, of Satan, who tries to leave us in bondage, in under him. But we are free men and women, sons and daughters, brides of Christ and the body of Christ, to be free from the manacles and the chains of the pitiful Satans and rulers of this world. We are not fearful. We refuse to live in the spirit of fear. And we agree where two or more are gathered in his name and proclaim and declare that we are sons and daughters of God. No longer slaves. No longer prisoners. No longer bound. But in his goodness, in his grace, in his mercy and loving kindness, we have found new life. New blood, new lineage. I am no longer of the lineage of Satan, of Lucifer, but I am of the lineage of Almighty God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He that is above every ruler and every name. We are in direct line with him. And I don't care if the devils are angry and if they are gnashing their teeth. Because it is time when they are of greatest power, where they are weakest, most visible for eyes to see their corruption, their immorality, their licentiousness, their murdering ways.
and for the people of God to not stand in the spirit of timidity, but to rise up like a roaring lion against the great dragon, an ancient serpent that tries to stand atop the necks of all men. Through the King, we pick up our swords of truth, our shields of faith, our weapons of warfare, our armor of righteousness, the belt of truth, the feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, and we stand mighty in battle against the forces of evil, and we reign victorious. You may kill these bodies, but you will never kill the Spirit of God. You have already lost, devil. You have already lost. And the people of God rise up with a mighty wind and the presence of the Holy Ghost, the spirit that is higher than any spirit, the Spirit of God that animates us in this animating contest for life, liberty, and the pursuit of God. We will never lose, devils. You devils, we will never lose. Because you can extinguish these lives. But the spirit of freedom, the spirit of liberty in Christ, cannot be killed. You cannot murder it, devil. You cannot behead it. To fall apart or fail. It will always come greater, stronger, more anointed. It's not in your nature. The more you try to quash the relationship with Christ, end up in pieces. The more you dig your own grave. You're never gonna let us down. You will die. And you will perish.
Somebody needs confidence.
And you will bow.
That he'll never let you down.
Before the greatness of the King.
He's been God a long time.
The glory of
heaven. He knows what he's doing.
That surrounds the King.
He knows what he's doing in you.
The kingdom that is coming.
When you don't believe,
and that requires warriors of Christ.
He knows.
Those who do not fear death, decapitation, or any murderous thing you try to threaten us with. Because God, our Father, whom we have eternal fellowship, relationship with, is reigning on high and reigns over the rulers of the earth. The pitiful totalitarian who in the eyes of God are nothing but maggots eating flesh.
because the rising, roaring giant that is humanity, that is your children who know who they are in relation to the Creator, who are endowed with inalienable rights which no devil can ever take. We bring fear into you, devil. When you look at us, you tremble because you are weak, devil. When you look at true men and women of God, you tremble, you weak fraud. And you will be defeated. And the glory of the kingdom will overtake you and destroy you. Yes, God. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, God, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God. He reigns in authority and power and might. King of heaven and earth, reigneth on high. Never to be vanquished. You can no longer scare us with tribulation, Satan. For we know in great tribulation is a greater kingdom that is coming. There is a time clock that is ticking for your power, devil. The countdown has already begun. And the more you persecute the children of God, the more, the greater your destruction shall be. Because the kingdom of the King of Kings, of freedom and responsibility, of truth, justice, and righteousness is coming. And we will see the day where God's kingdom and His children shall be free, free, free once again. We want to celebrate the kingdom that is coming.
Hi, everyone.
Come down, Angela. Come, sister. Come down, Angela. Come down, sister. Come, come. Sister Leila. Sister Leila. Sister Leila. Be free. Be free.
Fire in our eyes. Our lives are alive.
Come, my brother. Come. Come here, come here, come here.
Forever bright, your
come here.
Glory's breaking through the night. Oh, you will never fade away.
Tell the devil, tell the devil to sit down in his place. Get in your place, Satan! Go down! original place, you're going down before the sons of God forever. And it's over. Amen, brother. Let's worship.
You wake within
Come on, brother. Get up there. Get up there. Praise God. Come on, Lucy. Bring your husband. Bring your husband. Bring Jim. Bring him. Bring him. Come on. Sing in the presence of Father. Come on. Dance in his presence, Jim. Amen. Amen.
With fire in our eyes.
Fire in his eyes. His love is untamed. Untamed love.
Your glory is breaking through the night. You will never fade away. Your love is here to stay.
Untamed love.
Shining through it every day.
It's a choice to be tamed under the foot of Satan.
By my side, my life shining through me every day.
But an untamed love has power and anointing. Come on, young man.
You wake within me.
Praise God. Come on, my God. Join them, join them. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Wake within me. Oh,
he's got his camo. Come on, Rob. You got your camo on today. There's a warrior hunter. He hunts the devil. Amen, amen.
Forever,
forever. In his untamed love. Hey, baby.
In your love.
Forever, yes, God.
Forever, in your love.
Come on, brother. God.
You will never fade away.
You'll never fade
Your
away.
Stay by my side.
On your
my
side.
Life shines through me every day.
Until
you fade away.
The power of the Spirit of God. With real power and anointing. Amen. Yes. Richard Panzer. Richard. God saves even hippies.
Wake within me.
Yo,
in my heart.
Yes, Lord. He's in my heart.
Wake within me. You're in my heart forever.
Praise God. Praise God. Oh, yes, God. Yes, God. Come on, brother. He wants to jump for the Holy Ghost. Yes, God. Amen, 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 amen. 하나님 왕권 수립 승리 억만세. 만왕의 왕 전진 전무임 3대 왕권 억만세. 천이국 천건 킹덤 컴 억만세. Amen, amen. Hug your neighbor, guys. Hug your neighbor. Bless these young people. Bless these young people. Bless them. Bless them. Bless that young person back there. Back there. O'Brien, the O'Brien's daughters. Bless them too. Hug them. Hug them. Praise God. Praise God. Supernatural atmosphere.